Okay, everyone, here's my two-ingredient fudge, peanut butter and chocolate this time. So I warmed them up so I could start. I start by putting the chocolate icing in a bowl. Then I will add the peanut butter, warm it up in the microwave, and then let it cool and set. The first one was all just peanut butter flavor, and this time I have chocolate with it. So everybody asked, how is that gonna work? And I know it is going to be delicious because peanut butter and chocolate, what do you know? You just can't put that down. I shared the other peanut butter fudge with friends because I'm making this stuff, but no way can I eat all of it myself. So right now, I'm going to warm this up so it mixes up. Right now, it kind of looks like this. But I'm going to warm it up and it will be, and I'll be back. Okay, now I think I got it all mixed together, the peanut butter and the chocolate icing are all there. Oh, I got a clean spoon. I have to taste it. So, wow. Now I'm going to put it in a parchment lined pan and just let it cool off. It's very good. I thought it would be more chocolatey. I'm not sure what difference it will make when it is cool, but that is. He likes peanut butter, my dog, but you can't give a dog chocolate. So, anyway, I'm gonna scrape the rest of this out. And I'll let you know how it cools off and how it tastes after it has set a little while. Shouldn't take long. Okay, this was what I made last time, and that was just peanut butter and vanilla icing. And this is peanut butter and chocolate icing. And I just took a corner out of my pan because there's a lot of stuff in there. He's always got a bark. I wish it tasted it, Stella, a little less peanut butter and a little more chocolate, but it is good. Two ingredients, great to share for the holidays or anytime. And I just had to wait for it to cool off so it was not real liquidy. Very good. Until next time, that's all there is from Sunnybook Farm.